wife and her absent and everybody else that's here today. Amen. Amen. Special places. We are talking about conditions and endurance. Condition is a certain particular circumstances that people be in at a particular given time. You got all different types of circumstances. And, you know, Brother Bobby, he gave us the illustration of the military. And then he came to the scripture. You know, the scripture, it conditioned us to endure through any type of circumstances. To endure is to suffer too. You see, you can't endure and you don't suffer. You see, when you run a race, I never got up to a marathon. I got up to 15 miles every other day. But I couldn't, you know, my homie told me he ran a marathon. He said, if you can do 15, you can do a marathon. But my body, mind, and legs didn't say it. Because after 15, I was conditioned. I endured too. But I endured pain, but that pain, it built me up. But let me read the scripture, because I don't want the bell to ring on me before I read it. It says, wherefore, lay upon all filthiness and superfluity of naughtiness, and receive with meekness the engrafted word, which is able to save your soul. When we talking about superfluity, it's too much of something. You know, my babies had to get me right. You know, we took them to go see a movie the day on my birthday, and it had one of them had a lot of offenders. I said, I couldn't see that, so Queen put me to the side. You know, you used to cuss a lot. But you know, we didn't go see it. But you know, using too much of anything, if you start with just a little bit,
that's right,
then you're going to continue with more.
That's right.
But you know, we have to, you know, manage ourselves. But you know, it said the naughtiness, you know, anything that's filthy in us, God don't want us to have nothing filthy in us.
Right. Right.
And when we engraft something, you know, when you know in the medical field, Sister Najeen know what I'm talking about. The medical field, you know, a person may lose a piece of their skin somewhere there, and graft, take something off of one part and put it in another. But God wants us to engraft the word.
Right.
You engraft the word, it's in your heart.
Mm-hmm.
My sight is going bad, but if I go blind, if I didn't engraft the word, I would have no problem when somebody asked me what is Psalms 23.
Amen.
I know without a doubt of contradiction. I don't care what they say. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want.
Amen.
Let me leave it at that, y'all. God bless you.